फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वील प्रूव अ थियरम एज एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म बाउंडेडनेस थियरम. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव प्रूव्ड यूनिफॉर्म बाउंडेडनेस थियरम. सो दिस थियरम इज एन एप्लीकेशन ऑफ दैट. अ नॉन एम्प्टी सबसेट a non-empty subset X of norm linear space N is bounded if and only if fx image of x under f, if and only if fx is bounded for each f in n star. Let us see proof of this theorem. We are going to divide the proof in two parts because it is biconditional statement, if and only if. So what the theorem states: a non-empty subset X of norm-linear space N is bounded if and only if fx is bounded for each f in N star. First part, we assume that X is bounded subset of N. Let X be a bounded subset of N, where N is non-linear space. Take F belongs to N star. Since X is bounded subset of N, there is M, a real number M, positive real number M, such that norm of X is less equal to M for all X belongs to M. Sorry, for all X belongs to X. This implies that norm of fx, now it is true that for any functional or any operator, it is always true that norm of tx is always less equal to norm t into norm x. So this is going to be less than what? Norm f into norm x, and this is less equal to, by using this relation, this is going to be less equal to norm of f into norm of m, and let us call this as m dash. So norm of fx is less equal to m dash for all x belongs to x. This is what we wish to prove, that if x is bounded, then fx is bounded for each f in n star. So as f was arbitrary member in n star, we are done with the forward implication, one way implication. If x is bounded subset of n, then the fx is bounded for each f in n star. You could, for the sake of completeness, let me add this sentence, that is fx is bounded. Fx is bounded. So this completes the proof of first part. Now let us prove the converse in second part. So what will be converse? Let fx be bounded for each f in n star. Let fx be bounded for each f in n star, for each f in n star. We want to prove that x is bounded. Take x is equal to xi. We may say I belongs to I, where I is indexing set. The most crucial point in the proof of second part is this. X is subset of n, and in earlier sessions we have seen that n can be naturally embedded in n star star. So what is the mapping from n to n star star star? Phi is function from n to n star star. And if we define phi x as phi x is equal to capital F subscript x, where fx is defined by the relation fx of f is equal to fx for f belongs to n star, then phi is isometric isomorphism of n into n star star. So thus, with this relation, we may treat x as a subset of n star star under this mapping. So remember this, phi of x is equal to capital fx, where fx of f is defined as fx. This we have seen in some earlier session. In case you don't get this, I request you to refer to the corresponding video in our series of lectures in functional analysis. I repeat this, x can be treated as subset of n star star under this. So xi, we can say it is equal to fxi, where fxi is defined as fxi of f equals to f of xi for f belongs to n star. So let me specify this, is actually a subset of n. This is subset of n, and this is actually a subset of n star star, where fxi is defined as fxi of f equals to f of xi for f belongs to n star. Now let us begin with our hypothesis. Our hypothesis is that fx is bounded. By hypothesis, fx is bounded. So this implies that the set fxi इज बाउंडेड, बट वॉट इज एफ एक्स आई विद दिस डेफिनेशन? इट इज एफ एक्स आई ऑफ एफ इज बाउंडेड फॉर ऑल एफ इन एन स्टार. वी आर नाउ इन ए पोजिशन टू अप्लाई यूनिफॉर्म बाउंडेडनेस थियरम. So if this happens by uniform boundedness theorem, we can say that the set fxi itself is bounded. If this is bounded, then by uniform boundedness theorem, fxi is bounded, and as I mentioned, we are going to identify xi with fxi. So under isometric isomorphism, or let me put in this way, under natural embedding of n into n star star, n into n star star, we can say that fxi, that is xi, which is actually equals to x, is bounded. And this proves our claim that x is bounded. This is what we wanted to prove. Thank you.